Hey guys, what's going on? It's your favorite mortgage lender, Abdel Kouami, Paramount Residential Mortgage Group of my team, the Mortgage Plugs. I want to talk to you guys today in regards to contingencies. So when you're a first-time home buyer or a second-time buyer purchasing an investment property, everybody knows that they need to place an offer on a home when it gets accepted. An offer on a home is a legally binding contract eventually when it's signed, advising that you agree to the terms of the contract between the buyer and the seller. Now, contingencies is an event or something that can happen in the future that you do not know the predetermined results as of now. And three common contingencies that come into play is a finance contingency, an inspection contingency, and an appraisal contingency. During the extremely competitiveness of the market right now, two very common contingencies that are more or less getting waived or becoming a very common topic is the inspection contingency and the appraisal contingency. The financing contingencies, for the most part, is very common in a lot of different attorney review letters, and it basically just advises that if the buyer is unable to obtain financing, then he can't qualify for the home and the deal is canceled. Now, when it comes to inspection contingencies, every homeowner generally has the opportunity to have an inspection done right after their attorney review. An inspection will check the foundation, mold, asbestos, or any major issues that may pose an issue. Okay, during the competitiveness of this market, a lot of sellers are waiving the inspection contingencies, really just to the minimal, if that, of structural issues or environmental issues. Okay, so something to definitely keep in mind, if a house does need repair, the buyer may be obligated to have to cover those inspection contingencies to be able to even get the mortgage. And then you have the appraisal contingency, and this is probably one of the most common factors that's coming into play right now. So let's say, for example, homeowners right now are offering over $50,000, $60,000, sometimes I've seen even $100,000 more than the house is listed at. So the house is listed at $300,000 and you offer $350,000, okay? You need to, if there's a waiver of the appraisal contingencies, the buyer must be able to cover that difference of $50,000. Now, if the house appraises more than what you offered for, then you're good. If the house appraises at 100% of what you offered, then you're good. It satisfies the purchase price of what you can offer. Okay, super, super important for our homeowners to keep that in mind when you're looking to place your offers and there's a waiver of the appraisal contingencies. You as the borrower must be able to agree to that waiver and be able to cover the difference if it warrants that to be able to do it. If you guys have any questions, feel free to give us a call.